Hi students, welcome to this platform of English reading. Here I am going to teach you the first poem of your first chapter. The name of the poem is The Ant and the Cricket, which is adapted from Aesop's fable. The Ant and the Cricket is a fable written in the form of a poem by the Greek writer Aesop. A fable is a short story in which animals behave like humans and of course convey a message or moral. This poem about an ant and cricket contains an idea of far-reaching significance, which is as true of a four-legged cricket and of a two-legged one. Here the word cricket is not a game, whereas it is a grasshopper-like insect and is the other animal mentioned in the poem. The cricket was silly and was fun-loving, and it did not care about the future and kept enjoying the summer season rather than collecting food or making a shelter for itself for the winter season. The ant did not make a provision for food for the cold and wet months. On the other hand, the ant was wise. Instead of wasting time, it gathered food for itself and made shelter for the winter season. The ant was far-sighted. He was active, he was laborious. Really, the ant loved merrymaking. He used to sing all through the pleasant sunny months of summer and spring. He was short-sighted. He did not bother to store food for the rainy season and cold winter. This is all about the ant and the cricket. Now let us read the first stanza of the poem. A silly young cricket, accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring, began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and was come and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground, not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me? At last, by starvation and famine, made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold, away he set off to a miserly ant. Okay, students, now we will see the explanation of these lines. Here the poet says that there was a silly young cricket who was accustomed to sing. Here the word accustomed to sing means he used to or liked to or even made a habit to sing. He really enjoyed singing during the summer and spring seasons. The poet calls the summer and spring seasons gay here. See the word gay mentioned here. Here the word gay means happy, because there are full of life during these seasons. There is greenery everywhere. Food and water, everything is in abundant. However, soon those months he rejoiced and enjoyed like anything. And the months just passed out and winter came very soon. The winter came. Now the cricket was in trouble. See the condition of the cricket. Now he was in trouble. Because he did not make provisions for food for the coming cold and wet months. He began to complain when he found that his cupboard was empty. There was not even a crumb. Here the word crumb means piece of bread. He could not see even one flower or leaf on a tree. Seeing all these, he became very sad. Oh, what will become of me? He thought about himself. Now we have to think some questions in our own mind. See, some of the questions I want to mention here is, why does the poet call the cricket foolish? Why does the poet call the cricket foolish? The poet calls the cricket foolish because he is short-sighted. What did the cricket do all summer months? I already explained that the cricket sang all throughout the summer months. And finally he became very sad because he was hungry. He became sad because he was hungry. And see, the poet used the phrase accustomed to sing. Here the word accustomed to mean used to. I already told you that the meaning of the word accustomed to means used to. Let's see the remaining lines. To see if to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain and a mouthful of grain. He wished only to borrow, he would repay it tomorrow. If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. Says the ant to the cricket, I am your servant and friend. But we ants never borrow, we ants never lend. But tell me, dear cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm? Quoth the cricket, not I. My heart was so light that I sang day and night. For all nature looked gay, you sang, sir, you say? Go then, say the cricket, say the ant, and dance the winter away. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket, and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. Folks call this a fable. I will warrant it to true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. Here, when the earth was covered with ice and snow, the ant found that he had nothing to eat. There were no flowers and no leaves on the trees. I already told you that he did not see any leaf or flower on a tree. He grew nervous. He lost his boldness. Starvation could be seen over his face. He thought that if he did not get any help from anyone, he would die of starvation. Wet with the rain and shivering with the cold, the hungry cricket went to an ant to get shelter and food. Anyway, the cricket mustered its courage and set off to seek the help of a miserly ant to provide a shelter and food. He made it clear that he would return the borrowed grain the next day. The cricket requested the ant that he would repay it the following day. Now let us see, this ant is of course is a miserly ant. This miserly ant said humbly that he was the servant and friend of the cricket. The cricket says, see those lines in the poem. The ant said that we are your servants and friends. And but as a matter of principle, the ants neither borrow nor lend. He asked why he never bothered to store something for the rainy day. Now, the cricket was questioned by the ant and asked him why he spent all throughout the winter summer season by singing and dancing. The cricket admitted that he had been careless and foolish. Cricket understood that he would die of starvation, and he learned a lesson, and he admitted his mistake, and he said that he was careless and foolish. He enjoyed the beauties of summer and sang merrily. He spent his entire day by singing, and he ate and made merry. The ant then told him bluntly to go and dance all winter. He turned the poor cricket out of his house. Dear students, we have to think that if we don't do any hard work, there will not be any people to help you out, as we already learned in the case of this cricket and the ant. The cricket was very silly, and he spent through his entire day spending singing and dancing. He did not do any hard work, and when the difficult time came, there was no one to help him. Here we have to think that the cricket became bold because of the acute hunger. When he became hunger made him bold. Then he approached the ant and requested him to grant some shelter, food, water, etc. See the last two lines of the poem. Folks call this a fable. I will warrant it true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. Here the word folks means the people. People call this poem, this fable is a false story. And the poet warrant it that some crickets have four legs. There are some crickets who are active. That means they have four legs, and there are many crickets lazy. They have two legs. That is in the matter of human beings also. Among us also, there are many people who do hard work, and there are a few people who are lazy, just as like the cricket. People say that this story of the cricket and the ant is imaginary or a fable with a moral. But the poet thinks that the story is true and educative. Some people live only in the present. They spend what they earn and make merry. But they regret this habit later on. We know that there are people who spent more money, and they do not care about the next day, but they will really regret in their long run. This poem conveys a very realistic message. Of course, it shows if one does not think for future, he is destined to suffer. The cricket in the story represents those human beings who are not wise enough to save for future. Such poor fellows face very awkward situation, as the cricket had to. It is a humiliating situation, no? It makes them weak and morally down. But there are people like the ant who are bold. Their boldness is only due to their planned life. Say, I already told you that the ant is far-reaching. It has got a far-reaching significance. It thinks about the future. The ant thinks about the future. I mean to say that the ant was a far-sighted animal. They live happily forever. It is our real life. We should be like the ant, not the cricket. It makes our life comfortable. Really, if we are doing hard work, we can live our life comfortably. So, dear friends, now I would like to say the story in nutshell. I would like to say the story in a few sentences. The cricket was fun-loving. He enjoyed singing all through summer season. He did not store any food for winter. Naturally, the silly creature began to starve. There was only snow all around. He was wet. He decided to go to the ant to ask for help and shelter. He promised to repay the borrowed food on the next day. The ant told that they neither lent nor borrowed. Since the cricket had been singing in summer, he should dance the winter away. The ant finally told him bluntly to go and dance all winter. Means dance the winter away means to spend the winter as you spend the summer by singing. Like that, you spend the winter by dancing. He turned the poor cricket out of his house. So students, that is all for today's class, and I hope you all have understood the poem. If you have any doubt regarding the poem, do let me know in the comment section below, and please don't forget to like and subscribe this channel. Thank you.